this moment, only in my dreams, you're missing, but you're always a heartbeat from me. I'm lost now without you. I don't know where you are. I keep watching, I keep hoping, but time keeps us apart. Is there a way I can find you? Is there a sign I should know? Is there a road I could follow to bring you? Lies before me. Now you're so far away. In the darkness of my dreaming, the light of you will stay.
So good morning and welcome to day 3 of the Captain's Blog, and a glorious day it already is. Apparently, according to the radio, they're saying this is going to be the hottest day of the year so far, which is fine by me. Feeling quite perky, had an early night. Sorry for the rough sea dog kind of look. Only had time this morning for a wash of the face and a brush of the teeth because I had to leave Sutton Staithe at around 7:30 because I need to get to Wroxham. Trips on the Northern Broads go, this is going to be a bit of a longer one. I need to meet my girlfriend at the station, so I need to get there, find a mooring, walk to the station and pick her up. No doubt then she'll want to go shopping and stuff. So that's really what's planned today. After that, then this whole adventure will change into a kind of a sightseeing trip, I suspect. And we'll probably try and squeeze in 2 days as much as we can to show her this is this and this is that. And so my plan of having a very low fuel use will go out the window, I suspect. And having a brief look online, I do believe this has actually a 50 horsepower diesel in this boat. So compared to sort of 35, 38 horsepower of some of the higher boats, then obviously this is going to be more thirsty. We're on the River Ant at the moment. It is absolutely dead still, the water, and it is just one of those days you feel that it's going to be a nice day, you know. It's a bit like in the summertime when you wake up, you go out, and it's already kind of tingly on the face, the heat, and you think today's going to be a nice hot day. It's a bit like that. There's a lot of bird activity going on, you know, nature's woken up and thought, hello, today's going to be a good day to forage. So yes, it's going to be a bit of a day as far as the cruising goes. Can't see it, but I've used the bin as a footrest, because the bar to put your feet on when the chair's up so you can see out the windows properly is a bit low. So that has now solved the problem of dangling legs. the sunglasses is about to make an appearance. We're just past the moorings here for Howe Hill, and it has been an absolutely lovely meander down the River Ram. It's an absolutely glorious morning, and things seem to be getting better and better as it goes on. So it won't be too long before we're at the moorings of Ludden Bridge, and then we come under the bridge, obviously, and then turn right onto the River Bure. I'm going to be stopping off shortly and having a shave and a shower, since I've been able to obviously have nice hot water now going along, and then make my way into Wroxham, looking good. And look, I'm not sure about this, the whole t-shirt under the top, it looks a bit, I don't know, it's quite comfortable and warm, but yeah, and the hair needs sorting. Oh god, I just become vain because I'm on camera. We're now at the mouth of the River Rant, where it joins with the Bure, and we're going to be turning right and heading off towards Wroxham. I'm going to be stopping off somewhere along the way, as I say, to get ready. I was going to stop on the River Rant, but she's only gone and got the wrong train. So she's on the train an hour earlier than I was anticipating. So instead of being like, okay, well, you get there at one and, you know, take my time, go to the, maybe more in the boatyard, tidy the boat up a bit. Now it's suddenly, I haven't got that leeway. And we'll have to quickly stop, get ready, find a mooring, and then find out where she is. All fun and games. And my seat's sinking. I'm going to have to bring my seat back up again. All fun and games. Like, at the end of the day, I'll be like, hello, new old driver. Join me here at what I would call Wroxham Spit Moorings, although they probably have an alternative name, but they're just the other side, the river side, of the first entrance along from Wroxham Broad, which, as you probably can see behind me, stretches out some way. And I've come here basically to get ready properly and tidy the boat through quickly, and then it's not long actually into Wroxham itself, where I can then moor up hopefully easily and go to the station. So just to give you an idea though of just how pretty and nice a day this is, I'm going to swing the camera around here and just show you. So as you can see, it really is blue skies, bright sunshine and very peaceful. Be even more peaceful when I turn the engine off. Oh, and when this helicopter goes. But you get the idea though, it really is a lovely mooring here. It's very safe, it's got this soft bark chipping put down, it's got these glow-in-the-dark things which allow you to see at night time where the river edge is. The only sort of problem are they've used these hefty posts which make getting, you know, normal ropes round a little bit of a pain. There are some thinner ones or normal posts just down there, but no, these are really nice. I'm sure the fishing would be good from these as well. And a place I've never stopped before. Anyway, I must get on. So, more as it happens. So, I've left my mooring at Wroxham Broad, got changed and ready, and I'm now heading the short distance from Wroxham Broad, which is just on my left-hand side, to Wroxham itself. Now, hopefully, the easiest option would, of course, be to moor in Barnes Brinkcraft and wander into Wroxham from there. However, they don't have too many boats out at the moment, and space was especially tight when I took the boat over on Monday. So it possibly will be outside the Hotel Wroxham, or the cafe just along the way from the Hotel Wroxham, and so obviously we'll attempt not to screw up the mooring too much, considering there's the Hotel Wroxham webcam there. So in front of me is a day boat and the trip boat from Broads Tours, and they're having a great time, seen quite a few day boats out already. So season's really kind of starting off now, and I'm really pleased that I'm here as well. So that's all the update for now, more as it happens. So hi guys, and welcome to Hoveton and Wroxham Station, where I'm waiting for my partner to come on the train. However, the gods of cock-up have struck again, because her train never even left Norwich before it broke down. They couldn't even get it started, so everybody apparently has been taken off. They've tried to find a replacement diesel rail car thing to get here, so I don't know what time they'll be getting here, but it meant that the worry I had of being late and not being here on time came to nothing. I'm moored outside the cafe where the day boat hire is in Wroxham. Mustang from Alpha Craft is taking the mooring outside the Hotel Wroxham. So today is going to be one, I suppose, of sightseeing, showing new things to her, and I think we may well end up at the Bridge Inn at Acle tonight as an overnight, or we'll do a completely different thing, go back the way I've come up the River Rent and show her up there. So we'll see what happens, and you know, I'll update the blog as and when we decide where we're going and what's going on. So this is a bit new, so we'll see how it happens. So you join me here back on board after picking up my girlfriend, and you'll notice I'm not on the helm. So she's literally just taken the helm for the first time in her life ever driving a boat in the last 5 minutes, and she's a natural because she's not overcorrecting the steering or anything. But I've chosen a boat that's a little bit sort of silly as far as the helm seat's concerned. So it's a bit high up and a bit away from the steering wheel. But this is Sheila. Sheila, this is the internet. Right, now you've been introduced.
Yes, I've been introduced. But where do you want me to go, left or right?
We're just going straight. We're actually on Wroxham Broad at the moment. So as a complete newbie to this, what's your first impression?
It's fun.
It's fun. Okay.
It's fun.
So I think that means that anybody that's sort of thinking about coming on a boat and is not sure, it's fun. So I think you should get off your bums and come on a boating holiday. As you can see, the day has progressed into an almost summer-like day. And since I'm being chauffeured at the moment, I can do something amazing and actually come out to the rear of the boat. And it's you don't need sleeves today. That's how nice and warm it is. And this is March. So just an update for you guys. We've just come through Horning and Lower Street, etc. And we'll be shortly passing by the Horning Ferry Marina and then, of course, the Ferry Inn pub. So we're making good time. It's now 3 o'clock. Our destination for this evening is Acle, the Bridge Inn. So we've been into Roxham Broad and out, and we also went into Sowhouse Broad and out. So we're just taking nice and easy, pointing out the various places and Sheila looking at the map and seeing where we are and how far we've got to go and so on. And it seems like a lot of boats have, well, they're certainly not down this part of the Broads. We haven't really passed any hire boats or private boats to talk of. So the boats that I'd seen about earlier seem probably further up, I don't know, Potter Higham, River Ab and so on. What there has been a lot of is day boats. So certainly the season started good for those. And people thinking, let's, you know, take a day boat for a couple of hours in the sunshine. And because it's a weekday, it's not a weekend. So very enjoyable. Now it's sort of late afternoon, there's a little bit more of a chill in the air. After all, it is March, and early March at that. But you can't complain when the sun's out and it's not raining. That's the main thing. So I'll update you as and when. So more as it happens. So we're now on the last part of our journey today. We've just passed by just the mouth of the River Thurn. We're heading off down towards Acle. On the long straight part that follows the river from the mouth of the Thurn. So it is now 4 o'clock, so we'll be there well before it gets dark or the sun even sets. And looking forward to heading into the Bridge Inn for a couple of ales. Not sure if we'll be dining there tonight. We'll sort of see what's on board and how things are going. Probably going to be meeting up with a couple of people as well there as at the moorings already, called Ambition and Cheshire Cat. So should be a nice evening actually. And if you look out the window, just see how wonderful the evening is as the sun is lower in the sky now. Still really lovely blue skies.
Running through shadows, so make my way. Distant sound of voices, choose to look away. But I need something to keep me alive, to feel from the inside. Driving on empty, ride alone. I'm praying to an angel that says, go on.
Too long before we're at Acle Bridge and our final mooring for today, the Bridge Inn at Acle. And if you're a Norfolk Broads Forum member, that's the-norfolk-broads.co.uk, and you print your forum logo off, you're entitled to free moorings outside the Bridge Inn. It's been a fabulous day for me because it started off fine and dry, and then I've got the added benefit now having met with Sheena, my girlfriend. We can have a nice evening tonight, and she's already taken to boat handling and boating as a whole as really something she enjoys. So that's good, because you're never too sure if someone's never been before, are they going to like it? Are they going to say, oh, it's awful? Now, because I don't want to count my chickens before they hatch, because she might decide that, you know, the shower's too poopy, the birds are too hard, or whatever. Compromises always happen on boating, but the being away from it all, the sheer scenery, the loveliness of the Norfolk Broads often makes up for those. So, until we get to the Bridge Inn at Acle, or as it happens. So, here we are at the Bridge Inn Acle, and I'm joined by a couple of boats, which I'll show you in a moment. But it's a lovely evening, the sun is now setting, there's only three boats here this evening. Beating in the Bridge Inn, which is behind me, and I can thoroughly recommend this. It's a really lovely place, does excellent food, great choice of beers, wines, spirits, very friendly, very nice staff. And if you eat here, and even if you're just turning up, you know, on a private boat or a boat that doesn't display the NBF logo, the £5 mooring fee, which I think is well worth it anyway, is refundable if you're eating. So it's an all-in kind of thing. And of course, you've also got the large play area for the kids. And in the summertime, because this really is full up with people, it's a really great destination to come to. It's also the type of place, if you've come for a long drag up the River Bure from Yarmouth, having crossed Breydon Water, it's a nice place to stop and have a nice evening meal. So there is Acle Bridge, and in front of us is Broad Ambition. And then over here, as you can see, is the Bridge Inn. And the outside space seems to be possibly an outside pool table they've got there. Unusual. There's a complete sort of amusements and outside play area and goodness knows what. And then here we've got Cheshire Cat, which is very well looked after, and improved Hampton 25, Hampton Safari. And then of course here is Brinks Omega, which, as I walk back, it's quite a sleek boat from the outside, as you can see. It's very similar to Broom 29 sedans, it's just slightly longer and slightly wider. Also note the new Blake's logo. So that ends today's Captain's Blog. Until tomorrow, where currently we're thinking about going to what time to begin the day. We pick up tomorrow.